has just arrived from South Africa on the Hornchurch. He's come to see his sister who lives in Steeltown. Steeltown is an unfriendly place full of villains and vagabonds. Apparently, his sister has just had some diamonds stolen while she was flying over Egypt in her aeroplane. This is a story of Leighton Mouse and a case of a missing diamonds. Leighton has been knocking on his sister's door, trying to get an answer for the past 5 minutes. Strangely enough, a plane's not there. A car's there though, so she must be out flying. Leighton can hear his sister's plane approaching in background, so he decides to move a car out of the way so she can park. Finally, Leighton's sisters arrived home. Leighton was hungry after his trip on the Hornchurch, and Amy was wanting to fix her bike. She was due out on patrol that evening, and she was having problems with it. Amy told Leighton about her disastrous trip to Egypt, and how she was confronted by two robbers at gunpoint at the pyramids. Leighton wanted to know more, and if she was going back for her diamonds. It wasn't like Amy to let anything get the better of her. Sure, I'm going back, but I need you with me. How about we go back tomorrow, said Leighton. Amy was doubtful. I've got my patrol and this bike wants fixing. Leighton said the best time to go after a thief is straight after the crime. Why don't we take off for Egypt in the morning? In the meantime, we could use some rest. Amy and Leighton are ready for their trip back to Egypt. Amy fires up the plane, ready to taxi down the street. Amy and Leighton have finally arrived in Cairo, Egypt, and are about to land at the pyramids.
They decided to park the plane for the night near the pyramids and light a fire. Amy was cold, so she put a poncho on and Leighton took refuge in the tent. "It's getting dark," said Amy. "I think we should try and keep warm and continue in the morning. We'll head off into Cairo. Someone's got to be selling the diamonds on the map."
The next morning, Amy decided to work on the plane. She thinks the fuel pump had sprung a leak during the flight. Leighton decided to go around the local market, see if he can find out.
The market stallholder recognised Leighton straight away. "You're Leighton Mouse, the famous detective. I heard about what happened to your sister. I know who stole the diamonds. Ali Mamoon, that's the man you want. Where can I find him?" asked Leighton. "He owns a carpet stall. He has a warehouse he keeps stock in. I bet you've had a long flight. Perhaps you should come to my house for tea and I'll tell you all about them."
Later that evening, the stallholder had invited Amy and Leighton over to his house for tea.
"I never introduced myself. I'm Ali Ahmed and I know who you are. You and Leighton are both quite famous."
"Fame has its downside," says Amy. "It doesn't always bring its own rewards."
"You want to try working on a market stall 7 days a week," says Ellie. "Anyway, back to the subject of the Mahmoods. They're both quite dangerous."
"I know," said Leighton. "I know all about them. They're two brothers who fly between Steel Town and Cairo and sometimes travel on the Hornchurch to raid cabins and loot jewellery. Amy's arrested them a few times. She's a patrol officer with the Steel Town Police. They steal diamonds and sell them to the highest bidder."
Meanwhile, back in Steel Town, the Mamoon brothers were planning another raid on the Hornchurch, which was due in Port Said, Egypt, anytime soon.
It was the end of a shift at the steelworks and the Mamoons were planning their raid on the Hornchurch. Ali Mamoon was talking about his contacts in Egypt who stole Amy's diamonds and how he was going to meet them on the Hornchurch and break into the safe in Lady Annabelle's cabin. George was concerned. "Leighton Mouse is in Egypt. He's been asking questions in the market." "So what," says Ellie, "we just avoid a pair of them. We'll close down the steelworks for a few days and nip over and get the diamonds. I'm going to sell them in Venice. They should fetch a few million, along with Lady Annabelle's."
The Hornchurch is coming into Port Said, Egypt. Amy and Leighton are waiting at the dock to board. Outside, but Leighton Mouse had to warn the captain about the Mamoons. The captain needed Leighton's help getting the ship out of port. His crew had disappeared for some reason. No problem, said Leighton. I'll act as first mate. Half throttle, engine one, steer to starboard. Leighton sent the orders down the tube and the engines fired into life. The captain was grateful to Leighton for his help and continued to steer. Leighton watched out of a window as the ship began to leave port. You've been a big help, said the captain. The thing is, I'm concerned about Lady Annabel. The Mamoon brothers are planning to blow the safe in her cabin. The telegraph room's behind her cabin. If they blow the safe near the telegraph room, the ship could be in danger, and we could be put in distress. Leighton looked concerned. I'll see what I can do, said Leighton. I'll start my... Me and Amy will start our investigation. Leighton and Amy didn't realise how much trouble the Hornchurch was in. Ali Mahmood was placing explosives near the bow of a ship to blow the ship up. Now they were in real danger. Ali Mahmood was returning after his mission to blow up the Hornchurch. Amy decided to enjoy a quiet moment on deck to herself. Is gonna run.
That's them leaving.
Amy finally met up with Lady Annabel. I was hoping to meet you. Your life is in danger. Annabel looks confused. Amy told Annabel about the Mahmoods and their plan to steal her diamonds. I'm totally shocked, says Annabel. I only came on this voyage for a bit of peace and quiet. Lol, that's about... The explosion had knocked Annabel off her feet. Amy would have to... The Mahmood brothers were taking advantage of an explosion to rob Lady Annabel's safe. The women and children rule meant Lady Annabel had to get into a lifeboat fairly quick. Ali Mahmood had laced the safe with explosives and he was about to blow it. Lady Annabel had a substantial amount of money and jewellery in the safe. So Ali Mahmood made the best he could by stealing it. The
Hornchurch was sinking fast. Lady Annabelle and most of her survivors had managed to get into lifeboats. Alan Mahmood was making his escape on a powerful speedboat. The Hornchurch was sinking fast and going right down to the bottom of the ocean. It totally disappeared as a shipwreck. Miraculously, the captain of another boat had come out to rescue the survivors. Leighton Mouse was still on the ship.
Amy was meeting the Prime Minister to discuss the sinking of the Hornchurch. "I'm worried about Leighton," says Amy. "The last time I saw him was with the captain." "No need to worry," says the Prime Minister. "He was picked up in Greece by the authorities and is on his way back to London. He's meeting somebody from MI6. Meeting somebody from MI."
Leighton enters the room with the MI6 operative. Amy was pleased to see her brother was okay. "I'm Peter Franks, by the way. Ali Mamoon, he must be found. He's wanted here, and by Interpol, what he's done is equal to treason."
"I agree with that," says the Prime Minister. "Apparently he's wanted by Interpol in Europe and also in the United States. Have you any ideas how we're going to go about catching this Ali Mamoon?"
"Would you mind if I sat down?" asked Peter. "I've had a long journey from Greece."
Amy had gone to get a cup of tea while Peter sat beside the Prime Minister. "I have some ideas," says Peter. "The centre of European diamond trade is in Venice, at the Diamond Exchange. I've no doubt Ali Mamoon is in Venice and he's looking to trade Lady Annabelle's diamonds. He's probably on the run as well. My chief operative at MI6, he's been all over Venice looking for Leighton, but hasn't found him. We've got people all over Europe." "Leighton," says the Prime Minister, "I want you and Amy to fly straight into Venice. We picked up your plane in Egypt and fitted it with floats to land on the canal. So far, no one at MI6 or the Italian police has come forward with the sighting of Ali Mamoon. If you can locate him, follow him and call the minister in London. I'll give you a direct line into Whitehall. Mahmood must be found at all costs. Good luck." "I'll do what I can," says Leighton. "Me and Amy will be straight on the case after this meeting." "By the way," says the Prime Minister, "we're planning to raise the Hornchurch. We want to bring it to the surface to find out what really happened. See if we can come up with any clues."
"Get away on the speedboat."
Meanwhile, off the coast of Greece, a team of divers were preparing to survey the wreck of a Hornchurch. The divers were being lowered into the water slowly. Gradually, the divers were sunk to the bottom of the ocean. It took the divers some time to locate the wreckage of the Horn Church. They were both swimming aimlessly around at first. The Horn Church was lying on the seabed. The bow of the ship had been completely broke off when it sank and lay in a separate section. The bow was laying in a section on its own at the bottom of a seabed. Gradually, the wreck of a Horn Church was being raised after having steel struts put underneath it. Slowly it lifted out of the water, off its seabed, and broke the surface. Good luck. The Horn Church had been completely raised to the surface, all apart from the bow section which was coming next. The bow was slowly being raised to the surface after being put on jacks. It broke the surface. Amy and Leighton were about to taxi down the Thames on their way to Venice. They were passing the Houses of Parliament. Amy fired up the plane. Amy had probably achieved what was one of her first landings by aeroplane on the Grand Canal at Venice. She was really relieved that she hadn't crashed into the bridge. Amy parked the plane up on the canal. It wasn't easy landing on the canal. Now she could search for Alima. Amy and Leighton had spent the night on a gondola on the canal. They didn't get much sleep because of the noise from the cafes and bars. They decided to have breakfast and wait for the diamond exchange to open. Leighton was surprised when he got inside a diamond exchange. The Prime Minister, along with Peter Franks, was waiting for them. "So," asked Leighton, "where is the exchange manager?" "We don't know," said the Prime Minister. "We think he was kidnapped. Anyway, I spoke to his assistant this morning. And apparently, Ali Mamoon has been in trying to sell some diamonds." And what aroused his suspicion was, he was wearing a quartz converter. "What's a quartz converter?" asked Peter. "Well, apparently, some were made under license to an arms dealer called Lance Raymond. He lives up in India somewhere, so that's your next part of course." Ali Mamoon had landed at the secret hideout of Alice Tombs in the Himalayan mountains, a notorious weapons builder. Ali Mamoon was in the secret hideout of Alice Tombs, looking at his latest collection of secret weapons. "You have done well," said Alice. "I didn't sell any of Lady Annabelle's diamonds." "We need them anyway," said Alice. "I'll show you the satellite I built. This is the rocket I'm going to launch."
This is the Death Ray satellite. It started as a communication satellite, and I added my own touch of Death Ray. But in order to work, it needs a quartz converter. Lady Annabelle's diamonds are the converter. Once I get the satellite in orbit, I can position it so it points at the United States. I did a deal with the Russians on the rocket. When the satellite is up and running, I can point it up at the United States and fire the nuclear warhead straight into the country. I will demand $3 billion in UK sterling or destroy the US with a nuclear warhead on the rocket. I'm impressed, said Ellie. I have the diamonds.
Alice spills the diamonds on the table. "Now," says Alice, "I have no more use for you. You might as well die." Leighton Mouse had successfully landed at the lair of Alice Tombs. Now all he had to do was find a way in. Leighton had found his way into the lair of Alice Tombs, and now he was confronted with a big door to get through to the main chamber. Fortunately, he had a drill with him. Leighton positioned the drill exactly to drill through the door. Finally, with one big push of a door, Leighton pushed it in. Once inside the lair of Alice Tombs, Leighton found himself confronted by the villain himself. "So, Leighton Mouse, we meet at last. You come to destroy my rocket. Your plan won't succeed," says Leighton. Leighton was in serious danger. He found himself underwater. He didn't know exactly where he was going either. He only had something like 2 minutes of air left. He tried desperately to find a way out, but couldn't find one. Finally, he saw a tunnel. He couldn't exactly see where the tunnel went, but he made his way slowly. Found a self-destruct mechanism to the cave. Now all he had to do was press the lever. Leighton. Thank you.
After full refit, the Hornchurch was ready to sail again. She was being relaunched on the Thames in London.
She made her way slowly down the Thames. Watching the relaunch was Leighton Mouse and the Prime Minister. "It's a proud moment for me," says the Prime Minister, "finally getting Hornchurch relaunched." I'll second that," says Leighton. "Finally, I've managed to save the world."